Good day and God bless everyone. This is Queen Lindy Pitacora from North Central Mindanao College, taking Bachelor of Secondary Education, major in English, a second year student. In this video, I am going to discuss the first part of this theme 1, which is about upholding human dignity. Upholding human dignity is at the center of the value system that we associate with peace. So why does human dignity is associated with peace? As we all know, dignity is an innate right of a person. It is the intrinsic value of a person that need to be valued and respected by other people as well. Human dignity is rooted in the nature of human being, as it drives us to seek good, as it also helps us to determine what is right from wrong or the wrong from right, which also upholds or promotes the dignity of a human person. Human dignity is defined as the fundamental innate worth of a human being. It is also a principle that is now universally accepted but has not taken root in the actual practices of many governments, communities, and other non-state actors. So the human aspiration of for dignity and freedom belongs to every man or women alike. It could be from young or old. So we are all and have this right or the freedom. So human dignity is a universal. So it is the right for all. So human dignity is a fundamental guiding value for every person who has these rights as a person. So however, there are some cases or circumstances nowadays that there are still violations or the violations of the human rights for the other persons, like there are discriminations and among others. So we have here an example. This is an example of the women during the 19th century, in which women are regarded as weak and fragile. They have no right to access education. They have no rights to take to have a profession. They are only intended for household chores. So they were seemed to be as weak, and they have no strength like men can do. See, these were the some of the ideology or the beliefs of the men during the 19th century. So this is some of just the example of human rights being violated. So another one is the term racism. So a while ago, the pictures that I presented a while ago in the previous slide is about the sexism, in which they were the discrimination of the women before. And now, second picture is a racism, in which the person are being discriminated because of their race. So we have here an example, the Asian hate. So this was also relevant to nowadays, in which Asian people are gaining this too much hate and hatred from other people outside of the Asia continent. So these are just some of the examples of how the human rights are being violated. So we have here, the principle of human dignity is enshrined in the teaching of major faith. So human dignity, so understanding the concept of human dignity, it starts at the church itself. It starts to every religion, because religion teaches us on how to behave morally and how to on how to communicate with the other people appropriately without discriminating the other person or without putting down other people. Education that seeks to uphold human dignity is often referred to as human rights education, which is within the umbrella we call peace education. So, understanding this concept about upholding human dignity become part in the educational system, specifically in the curriculum, as it will give us an understanding the importance of the rights of every person about upholding human dignity. So we have here the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So the recognition of the human rights as a significant international concern came at the close of World War II with the founding of United Nations and the adoption of Universal Declaration of Human Rights, or known as the UDHR by the UN General Assembly in 1948. This is according to Flowers, 1998. So as you can see, because of this discrimination of this, it will make the people or the groups of people to be divided. So it will cause more confusions or possible could cause war. So that is why this concern during the previous centuries, the early centuries, sees this the importance of human rights to be uplifted. So there's in order to protect the people from discrimination, in order to raise the standard of living. So that is why there were these groups of people, especially the United Nations, they created this declaration of human rights for all, universally. So we have here the first, here are the articles that were embedded in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So it consists with a total of 30 articles. So the first article is which summarizes the right to equality. So everyone has the right to, we are all endowed with this conscience, with mind that should act towards one another in a spirit of brotherhood. So we should treat one another as equal, although there are rich and poor people. So we should treat each other as an equal person. So the second article is equality. We are all born with equal rights and dignity. So whether you are rich or poor, you have this right to equality in the society. Article 2, freedom from discrimination. So we are all entitled to all rights and freedoms without distinction of any kind, such as color, race, ethnicity, status, sex, age, language, religion, or it could be our political or other opinion. So we are all entitled to not to discriminate with one another because it is our right. The third article is the right to life, liberty, and personal security. So these are just some of the basic rights that are enjoyed by all of us right now. As we can see, we are having this freedom to live for ourselves and to have this personal security. So the article 4, freedom from slavery. So during the early centuries, we were experiencing this tragic slavery from other countries, because before, as we can remember, during the Spanish colonizers, Filipino were being slave by the Spaniards. So that was before, but now we because of this Universal Declaration of Human Rights, we have this freedom from slavery. The Article 5, which is freedom from torture and degrading treatment. So, we are all have this rights to free ourselves from this degrading treatment, from harassment, from violations, and other punishment. So we are having this right to free ourselves from this torture, degrading treatment. And the Article 6, right to recognition as a person before the law. So we as a person, we our rights should be recognized as a person. So we are, despite of the different statuses in life, whether you are poor or rich, you have this equal rights to be recognized as a person before the law. The Article 7, right to equality before the law. So all of us, everyone are entitled to equal protection against any violation and discrimination. The law should treat the person, each one of a person, either you are less fortunate or fortunate, either poor or rich, you need to be treated equally under the law. So, because the value of a person cannot be measured by the money. But because we are talking about here the rights of every person for all of for all, not for the wealth. So if the less fortunate people have violated any law and need to be punished, the same goes to the rich people. So we have an equality for all. So all, but it all depends to the kind of case or crime and the gravity that is included in the crime. So we have the next article, which is the Article 8, the right to remedy by competent tribunal. So everyone has the right to an effective remedy for the competent national tribunals for acts violating the fundamental rights and granted him by the Constitution or by the law. And the next one, the Article 9, freedom from arbitrary arrest and exile. So, no person should be arrested, so, or put into the detention or being imprisoned or be exiled without enough reason or evidences that the person is guilty and responsible of a crime. So the next one is the Article 10, right for fair from public hearing. So everyone has the right to be heard publicly. So in order to know their rights and their obligations and the possible charges or the possible cases, the charges against him. So we have here the next article, the Article 11, the right to be considered innocent until proven guilty. So everyone as being accused by the other person, he has the right to be heard and to be presumed innocent until he is proven to be guilty with the crime. And the number 12, freedom from interference with the privacy, family, home, and correspondence. So everyone has the right to the protection of the law against such interferences or any attacks. So no person is allowed to interfere with your personal or any sensitive information. It could be your messages, chats, emails, or personal documents. So no one is allowed to interfere with that because that is your privacy. You have this right for your privacy. So no one should allowed to interfere with that. So all of us has the right under the law against this interference. So the next one is the Article 13, which is right to free movement in and out of a country. Okay, so for example, you and your family wanted to settle in Canada. So you have the right to live in other places. So you have the right to move and in out of the places. If you were a Filipino and you wanted to go with the other places, or shall we say outside of the country, you have this right to settle in other places. As long as you have not violated any of the law. So the next article, which is the right to asylum in other countries from persecution. So everyone has the right to ask help. If a person has been degraded, that has no basis in his own country. So this right may not be inverted if that has no, if in the case of persecutions genuinely arising from non-political crimes, from act contrary to the purposes and principles of the United Nations. So the next one is the Article 15, the right to a nationality and freedom to change it. So everyone has the right to be converted. For example, if you were a Filipino and you wanted to be converted into an American, so you have that right as long as you did not as long as you have not violated any of the law, or you have just obey the conditions or some of the conditions under the law. So no one shall be arbitrarily deprived of his nationality nor denied the right to change his nationality. So the next article, which is the Article 16, the right to marriage and family. So everyone has the right to enter in the marriage and to have a family as long as you are 18 years old above. You can now intermarriage and to have a family. So this right, without any limitation due to race, nationality, or religion, everyone has the right for marriage and family. We have essentials and formal requisites of marriage included in the family code, and you have to follow in order to enjoy all of the rights in choosing your husband and wife. It should be free and full of consent between both of the spouses, so without forcing the other. Because it is a lifetime commitment, and the family is considered as the fundamental group unit of society and is entitled for protection by society and the state. So the next one is the Article 17, right to own property. So we have this all. Everyone has the equal right to own a property, as well as the right to co-ownership with two or more person that is allowed by the law. And the next one is the Article 18, which is freedom of belief and religion. So everyone has the freedom of choosing their own religion, their own beliefs, and their guiding principle in life. So the next one is the Article 19, freedom of opinion and information. So we are all entitled, everyone is entitled with their own expression. They're free to express themselves, their opinion, and their information. So this right is includes interference and to seek and receive an important information and ideas through any media and regardless of frontiers. So the next article, so Article 20, right of peaceful assembly and association. So everyone has the right to become part of any gatherings. It could be a demonstration or rally. We are free to do things, but we should not forget to obey the conditions or what are the laws or the regulations that we need to follow in a peaceful way, not in a destructive way. So without disregarding the law also, everyone has the right, yes, to be part of any gatherings in the public, but we should not force the other person to join us. And the next article is the Article 21, right to participate in government and in free elections. So everyone has the right to take part in any undertakings in the government. It is his right to participate in any activity. So everyone has the right to equal access to public service in his country. But there are also qualifications to be part of public service, in which the will of the people should be the basis of the authority. So the next one, and the next article, the Article 22. So, right to social security. Okay. Everyone has the right to have this equality or this security, social, in the sense of economic, social, and cultural, that is highly needed by a person in order to preserve his or her dignity. So the next one is the Article 23, right to desirable work and to join trade unions. So everyone has the right to work and the free choice of employment, just favorable conditions of work, and to protect against unemployment. That is why we have Department of Labor and Employment, or known as DOLE, that protects the rights of the employers. But also, we need to take note that there are qualifications that need to be practiced or possessed of an employee in order to be part of that program. So the next one is the Article 24, the right to rest and leisure. So including this reasonable limitations of working hours and periodic holidays with pay. So you should not let the workers work overtime, especially those who have mental and health conditions. So the next article is the Article 25, right to adequate living standard. Yes, so everyone has the right to adequate for the health and the well-being of himself and his family, including the food, clothing, housing, and medical care, and as necessary social services, the right to security in sickness, unemployment, disability, old age, widowhood, or other lack of livelihood in circumstances beyond his control. And the next part is the Article 26, which is the right to education. So everyone has the right to access education. A quality education for all, regardless of race, ethnicity, gender, age, and among others. Even if the person with the disability, you have this right to access to education. And the next article is the Article 27, right to participate in the cultural life of community. Okay, of course. Everyone has the right to enjoy the arts and to share in scientific advancement and its benefits. And the next is the Article 28, right to social order, that articulates this document. So, everyone has the right for social order, in which the rights and the freedom set forth in this declaration can be fully recognized. And the next article is the Article 29, community duties to essential to free and full development. So everyone has duties to the community in which allow the free and full development of his personality as possible. So these rights and freedoms may in no case be exercised contrary to the purposes and principles of the United Nations. So, the last article, which is freedom from state or personal interference with in the above rights. Nothing in this declaration of the human rights may be interpreted as the implying for any state, person, or any group right to engage in any activity or to perform any act aimed of the destruction of rights and freedoms set forth herein. So you are not allowed to abuse any of the rights that were given to you. So all of the rights under this declaration of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, all of the rights and freedoms has its own limitations and obligations. So here, okay, so out of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights in the different articles that I've discussed earlier, so we can conclude that there are five major types of human rights that people need to be valued or that need to be understood. We have here the civil rights, the political rights, the social rights, economic rights, and the cultural rights. And that would be my part. Thank you so much and God bless.